Hi, in this video, we'll go through some of the features of the Vizar software and also see how we can extend the current functionality pretty easily. In a nutshell, Vizar is a visual analysis framework. It was originally built to facilitate downstream analysis and exploration of next-generation sequencing data, but it can be used in a wide variety of application domains. In a typical workflow, we first add one or more data tables to the workspace. Then we add apps to the workspace by dragging them from the apps pane and assign data to them by dragging and dropping data tables onto them. Here we use the Table View app to browse and filter the data table. We can add several apps to our workspace. Here we can add a scatter plot and set some visual parameters using the parameters pane on the right hand side. For example, we set the axes to be log scale. Then we tell the app to use the name column for tooltips and use the chromosome column for coloring our data points. Apps can also be linked together. For example, here we can use our integrated IGV app, and since our data points have genomic locations such as chromosome start and end, if you click on the data points, the genome browser will browse to the corresponding location. These were a few built-in interactive apps in Vizar. However, the main power of Vizar actually comes from the apps that can be built using R. So let's start and make a simple app. An app is basically an R code together with a JSON file that is automatically created from the R code, and optionally an icon. An app is a standard R code. Here we'll use RStudio to create our app, but you can use virtually any text editor to create and edit the apps. There's even a simple editor built into Vizar. We start with a template code that has the few starting lines to define our app. Let's first save it as a new R code, say under examples, and name it myapp.r. If you run this empty template, it creates a JSON file and prints it out to the console. Now, if we go to Vizar, we will see that my app has appeared there. But it doesn't do anything yet, obviously, since we haven't added any functionality. So let's go and add some functionality into the app. Parameters in an app can be organized into categories. Let's add a category and name it input, and add a parameter and name it text. Now let's add our code. We'll start by plotting a uniform random distribution of 100 points. Now if you go back to VizR and open the app, we see that we have an input category with a single parameter named text. And if we run the app, we will get our uniform random plot. Now let's make the number of random points n as a parameter of the app. We also have to edit our code to use the newly added parameter vizar.param.n. We can set the parameter to have a default value of 100. Now back again to Vizar. Note that since we have specified the default integer, Vizar will know that this is an integer parameter and has created the proper UI control for it. We can continue adding more parameters based on our specific needs. Vizar has support for a variety of parameter types and automatically creates proper UI controls for the parameters, so you just have to focus on the functionality and don't need to worry about the details of building the UI. Apps will be much more useful if you can reuse them with any input data. So let's change our app so that it uses the data table that is assigned to the app. We can do this by using the variable vizar.input. We also want to be able to specify the columns used for x and y axes. So we will add a parameter x column of type column numerical and a Y column. Then we change our plot code to use those. To be able to debug our code outside Vizar, we can specify a debug data as the input to the app and debug value for any of the parameters. This way, all of our variable names will be initialized and we can run and debug our code in RStudio. Now let's practice what we have learned to create a more serious app. We will create a simple app to do differential expression analysis. We will use the famous EdgeR library and use the code from the user guide for the classic approach using the exact test method. We also initially use the test data referenced in the user guide, which is an RNA-seq recount table for Drosophila, which has multiple columns for different conditions and biological replicates.